So what are the ingredients we are using in compounding of plastic seeds? Online or offline? Maybe offline only, I think, because I think you have to come from 1st February. But in the news, we are getting the news like that. But every day it is changing, no? We'll see, okay? Maybe offline, I think. Okay, we'll see, ma. Every day they will change the news. Okay, ma. The following are the important additives or ingredients added to the polymer resin. So we are taking a resin first. Polymer we are taking, ma. Okay, na. For example, you are taking a polyvinyl chloride. To this polyvinyl chloride, we are going to add plasticizers, fillers, stabilizers, lubricants, accelerators, or catalyst, coloring materials. Okay, these are ingredients, additives we are adding to the resin. So the following are the important additives or ingredients added to the polymer resin. So remember, ma, what we are using the ingredients: plasticizers, fillers, stabilizers, lubricants, accelerators or catalyst, coloring materials. Okay. So first one is resin. So total 7 you remember, ma. Resin, plasticizers, fillers, stabilizers, lubricants, catalyst, coloring materials. So in compounding of plastics, first we take the resin, ma. Okay. So resin is the binder or polymer material. Polymer material which constitute the major portion of the plastic. Means we will take first resin only, polymer material we will take. Huh? So that we will take more percentage. Okay, like a 90% or 80% we will take the resin only. So as described earlier, okay, we discussed already in the earlier that there are two kind of resins. Huh? So one is thermoplastic resin, one is thermosetting resin. Okay, so thermoplastic resin, so that are fusible and remoldable. We know the differences also. We can go for reshape and okay. So that are fusible and remoldable. That are known as thermoplastic resins. Whereas the other type is thermosetting resin. That is the thermosetting resin. They are cross-linked polymers, cross-linked structure, which are non-fusible form. Because of the presence of strong covalent bonds. So these are known as thermosetting resins. Okay. So this type of like thermosetting resins, ma, they required catalyst. So we will add catalyst during molding process because to get a cross-linked structure, to convert fusible form of the resin to non-fusible form. For example, not all polymers. For example, one I will tell you, we'll take bakelite. When we are preparing the bakelite, okay, initially we'll get a fusible form of the resin we get. Okay, so to that we will add the catalyst hexamethylene tetramine. So when we add the catalyst, we will get a cross-linked structure. So here, the cross-linked non-fusible form of resin that are known as thermosetting plastics, which require catalyst during molding process. Okay. So resins, we are taking two types, ma, thermoplastic resins, thermosetting resins. For example, polyethylene resin, polyvinyl chloride, that is the resin. Okay. Now, second point is plasticizers. Only 50 are there. Hari, CR?
Yes, ma'am.
It's important class, ma. Compound plastic. Send one message again. Okay, na? Only 15 students are absent. Now, okay, plasticizers. Okay. Plasticizers, ma, we will add to the polymer material to increase the plasticity, and flexibility. Okay, so that we can mold into any shape. Okay. So plasticizers are chemicals. We are using chemicals here. So that are added to resin, to increase their plasticity and flexibility. Okay, so what are that plasticizers we are using now? Okay, we are using mostly the plasticizers are vegetable oils, triglyceride phosphate. We take only triglyceride, no need vegetable oils. So we'll use plasticizers are triglyceride phosphate, tributyl phosphate, triphenyl phosphate. Remember these three enough. So most commonly used plasticizers are triglyceride phosphate, tributyl phosphate, triphenyl phosphate. When we add plasticizers to the polymer resin, okay, ma? So this is polymer resin, okay? We are adding polymer chains, you can see, in polymer, okay? So when we add plasticizers to the polymer resin, so what happened here means the plasticizer molecules get inside the polymer chain. They will get inside the polymer chain. And neutralization of they will neutralize the intermolecular forces of attraction. Between molecule to molecule, there will be attraction will be there between polymer chains. So there will be attraction will be there. So this will neutralize the intermolecular forces of attraction between macromolecular polymer chains. Between macromolecular polymer chains. Okay. So here the breaking of what happens here due to plasticizers, they will break. Okay. Means they are going there. You see, the plasticizers will be, they will go and stay in between the polymer chains. Okay. They will occupy the space between the two polymer chains, you can see. Okay. So the breaking of intermolecular force. Okay. How the breaking will be taking place between the two polymer chains means here when this plasticizer, it will go and stay between the two polymer chain. Okay. So the breaking of intermolecular forces between polymer chain, that facilitates the free movement, greater freedom of movement of polymer chain. Okay. So attraction between the polymer chain will be decreasing when these plasticizers are added, because these plasticizers are breaking the forces between the polymer chain. They are going and staying between the polymer chains so that attraction will be less, and so that increasing flexibility and plasticity, thereby increasing flexibility of the plastic. So we can mold into any shape. Okay. So increasing the flexibility of the plastic by addition of plasticizers reduces the strength. So, but some disadvantage, like strength of the polymer resin will be, strength will be decreases. Okay. Reduces the strength and the chemical resistance of plastic. But to increase flexibility, plasticity, we will use plasticizers. Okay, but not reducing more strength, maybe a little bit some strength will be decreased. Okay, so for this purpose, to increase plasticity and flexibility, we are going to use plasticizers. For example, see the students, we are adding triglyceride phosphate. This is the chemical. So this we will add in polymer resin. We will add in polymer resin. So when we will add in polymer resin, so they will decrease the, or they will break the intermolecular forces between the polymer chains. So this plasticizers will go and stay between the polymer chains and increasing plasticity and flexibility. Okay, so that only I gave here. The breaking of intermolecular forces between polymer chains facilitate the easy movement of polymer chains or greater movement of polymer chains, thereby increasing flexibility of the plastic. Students will take polyvinyl chloride polymer resin. Without adding plasticizers, we can make helmet, for example, I'm telling. Okay. By adding plasticizers, you can make a raincoat or you can make tablecloth curtains with PVC. Okay, for example. Okay, so we'll take PVC, we will add plasticizers, and we'll go for some articles, some items we'll prepare. Okay, we'll get some molded articles. Without adding plasticizers also, we'll get some molded articles. Okay, so when it is needed to add plasticizers, then we will add plasticizers to the polymer resins and we go for the molding article. So this is about plasticizers, ma. Okay, so next one is fillers. So plasticizers we are adding to increase the plasticity and flexibility, okay, in the polymer resin, okay, so that we can mold into any shape. And next one is fillers are the materials. You see, I gave here barium sulfate and carborundum, silica carbide, and I gave some wood floor here, okay, wood floor. These are some examples of fillers, ma. Okay, na? So fillers, these fillers we will add in polymer resin. See, for example, you are taking one container. First, you are taking a polymer resin. Polymer resin, for example, polyvinyl chloride. Then you have added a triglycerol phosphate. After that, you are adding a carborundum, silica carbide, or wood floor you are adding, or barium sulfate. Okay. So now third one we are adding. Okay. Fillers are the materials added to the molding mixture in order to give better hardness. To increase the hardness of the polymer resin, we are going to add fillers to give better hardness, to increase the strength and opacity. Means it won't be like a transparent, like, okay, to increase the strength, opacity and workability to the plastic. Means we'll get a good finishing product, we'll get workability to the plastics. So for this purpose, we are adding fillers. Mainly, the first point you remember why we are adding fillers means to give better hardness, okay, then strength, opacity, and good finishing product, workability to the plastics. So these fillers, it will reduce the cost of the polymers. Nothing but this point why we are writing here means, now what we will do here in polymer industry means, polymer resin, they will take only 50%, ma. 50% like fillers they will take, okay? Because we'll get a good finishing product, increasing hardness. So some will go for compounding of plastics like that, and they will go for molding of plastics, ma. Okay? But not all the polymers, they will choose like that. They will add 50%. Okay, na? So that we wrote here point, fillers reduce the cost of the polymers and also reduce brittleness of the polymer. Okay, brittle means easily breakable. Okay, so by adding these fillers, it will reduce the brittleness of the polymer. So I give some points here. When we add carborundum, silica carbide. So when we add carborundum, silica carbide, quartz, that is also silica oxide, silicon oxide, and mica, okay, all these, when we are add, okay, So carborundum, silica carbide, and quartz, silicon dioxide, when we are adding, it increases the extra hardness. It provides extra hardness, improve the hardness. It provides extra hardness. So to get a better hardness, students, you remember what we are going to add in polymer resin is carborundum, that is silica carbide, and quartz. Barium salts we are adding, ma, to make the plastic impervious to X-rays. Means when you are adding a barium salt, barium sulfate into polymer resin and going for molding article, okay, when that is exposed, it does not allow X-rays, okay, it is impervious to X-rays. So barium salts are added to make the plastic impervious to X-rays. Now next one, addition of asbestos provides heat and corrosion resistance, okay, natural. This is addition of asbestos provides heat and corrosion resistance. So we will add asbestos also to polymer resin as a filler to provide heat, and it provides heat and corrosion resistance. It is resistance to heat and it is resistance to corrosion. Next, the percentage of fillers, we will add up to 50% to the total molding mixture, not completely 50%. So major percentage will take, ma, compared to other ingredients. Okay, so most commonly used fillers are wood floor, gypsum, calcium sulfate, barium sulfate, and sawdust. Sawdust also similar to wood floor only. Marble floor, cotton fibers will take. Okay, so students, if you can't remember this, you write compulsory this you have to write in fillers, carborundum, quartz. Okay, barium salt, asbestos, this compulsory you have to remember. If you want to remember, you can write this, at least three you can write. Wood floor, gypsum, okay, marble floor, you can write. So this is about fillers. Fillers are materials added to the molding mixture in order to give better hardness, strength, opacity, and workability to plastics. So to increase hardness, add carborundum, silica carbide, quartz. So to the barium salts are added to make the plastic impervious to X-rays. Asbestos provides heat and corrosion resistance. So this is about fillers. So already students, we have taken a polymer resin. We have added plasticizers. We have added fillers. Now fourth one is lubricants we are adding. Okay, in compounding of plastics, we are adding lubricants. So lubricants compulsory we have to add. Compulsory, because when you are making any bottle or any cup or any plate and all plastic, okay, anything, for example, chair, plastic chair is there, plastic table is there, a number of plastic items are there. When we are molding that articles or items, when we are taking that polymer material in that machine, okay, in that molding, molded parts, so we have to add compulsory this lubricating oil in our compounding of plastic, means in polymer resin we have to add, okay, so that when we are pouring or when we are taking that in molded machines or fabricating equipment, when we are taking that what we are taking a mixture of resin with ingredients, so this polymer material that does not stick to the fabricating equipment, that does not stick to the fabricating equipment. So lubricants are molding of to get molding of plastic easier. It makes the molding of plastic easier. They impart glossy finishing to the product. So this is also a good point. They impart glossy finishing to the product. So lubricants prevent molded article from sticking to the fabrication equipment. This is the point, students, why we are taking oils, why we are adding oil, okay, or any wax, any soap, stearates to the polymer resin, why we are adding means. So these lubricants, the oils prevents the molded article from sticking to the fabrication equipment. Okay, example, you can write wax, okay, oil, stearates, soaps, etc. So this is fourth one, ma. Okay, next one is what we are adding. So next one is we are taking accelerators. Okay, fifth one is we are adding catalyst. Accelerators are catalyst. So catalysts are mainly added to thermosetting plastic in order to accelerate the polymerization of fusible resin to cross-linked form. Fusible resin to cross-linked form during molding operation. If any fusible forms are there, fusible form of resin is there. So that also it will convert into cross-linked forms during molding operation. So catalysts are mainly added to thermosetting plastic in order to increase the polymerization of, in order to accelerate the polymerization of fusible resin to cross-linked forms during molding operation. So what we use mostly the catalyst in this process is hydrogen peroxide, benzoyl peroxide, metals like silver, copper and lead we can take, and metallic oxide like zinc oxide also we can add, okay, we can use as a catalyst. Students, you remember hydrogen peroxide, benzoyl peroxide, zinc oxide, okay, three you remember as a catalyst example, you remember three, okay. So if you can't remember all these, at least three you remember. Next, stabilizers. These stabilizers are added to the molding components ma, to improve thermal stability. Already I told you why we are using stabilizers means to improve the thermal stability. So it should be resistant to heat, no? Thermal stability of plastics during processing. During processing time, okay, to it should be stable to the heat. Okay, we will add stabilizers. So there are two kinds of stabilizers we use. Opaque molding stabilizers, okay, transparent molding stabilizers. Okay, opaque means not transparent. Second one is transparent molding stabilizers we take. So opaque molding stabilizers, what example we can take? These are mainly like lead salts, like lead chromate, white lead, lead silicate, okay, etc. are used in opaque molding. Transparent molding stabilizers, we use stearates of lead, okay, lead stearate, barium stearate, cadmium stearate. So this we will use as transparent molding stabilizers. So there are two types of stabilizers we use ma, in molding during process. So you remember example, lead chromate, white lead, two examples here, and here lead stearate and barium stearate and cadmium stearate, okay na? So this you remember example as stabilizers. So stabilizers we are using to the molding components to improve the thermal stability of plastics during processing. So we use mostly lead chromate we will add, and white lead we will add, and here we will take lead stearate, cadmium stearate, barium stearate. So students, till now we have taken, along with the polymer resin, we have added plasticizers and what else ma? Plasticizers,
resin.
First you have taken a polymer resin, then what are the ingredients you are adding? Plasticizers,
fillers,
lubricants,
catalyst,
stabilizers. Okay, last one is the colorants. Colors we have to use. Okay, so we have to get a good desired color. Okay, we will add colors. So colorants are coloring agents that are added to the molding mixture. So which gives desired color to plastics. So we have to get a desired color to plastics. We will add different colors we will take. So there are two types of pigments we are using, two types of coloring pigments, inorganic and organic coloring dyes we will use. I gave some example students here. Inorganic pigments like lead chromate, it is yellow color. So here also we are using lead chromate, okay, stabilizer. This is also like, it means we can use lead chromate as stabilizer and also color, okay. Lead chromate, okay, and iron ferrocyanin dyes, okay, blue color, iron ferrocyanin dyes, aluminium silicate, and organic colorants we will use, like I gave one example, thalocyanin dyes. It will get blue to green color, okay, thalocyanin dyes. So these are the examples of colors, ma, lead chromate, iron ferrocyanin dyes, aluminium silicate, and thalocyanin dyes. Four colors I have given, remember, okay. Lead chromate, iron ferrocyanin dyes, blue color, aluminium silicate, next thalocyanin dyes, blue to green color. So this is about compounding of plastics. Students, hello.
Yes ma'am.
Now, what type of resins we are taking, ma? How many types are there resins, sir? Three or four?
Two.
What are that? Two types of resins, sir.
Thermoplastic, thermosetting.
Thermoplastic resins, sir. Thermosetting resins, sir. Okay. Now, tell me the students, why we are using plasticizers, tell me.
To increase plasticity and flexibility.
Okay. So when we are adding plasticizers, what happens in the polymer resin?
Intermolding.
It is breaking the forces between the intermolecular forces between the polymer chains. It will break the nothing but neutralization will be taking place. It will break the intermolecular forces between the polymer chains so that there will be increasing flexibility and plasticity. So what is the function of plasticizer, students? Tell me in one line. Students, what is the function of plasticizers?
It increases plasticity, increases
plasticity and flexibility. Tell me examples now. Tell me examples. Students, just a minute. Okay, wait 1 minute. I'll... Okay, students. Hello.
Yes.
Okay, tell me examples of plasticizers. Just we will know the function and example. We'll remember. We can go for next topic. Tell me example. Students, tell me examples of plasticizers.
Tri-butyl phosphate. Tri-phenyl
phosphate.
Triphenyl phosphate.
Triphenyl phosphate. Tricrysyl phosphate. Remember at least two. Okay. Tricrysyl phosphate. Tributyl phosphate. Okay. Now fillers, why we are adding? Fillers, tell me. What is the function of fillers?
Hardness.
Do we improve the hardness?
Strength or capacity
and workability to plastics. Why we are adding silica carbide? Why we are adding silica carbide? What is the function?
To provide extra hardness.
Barium salts. Barium salts. Barium salts we are using. Why? Barium salts are added to the plastic.
It does to make not it plastic impervious to X-rays.
Impervious to X-rays. It does not allow the X-rays to pass. Okay. Asbestos we are adding. Why?
Provide heat and corrosion resistance.
And corrosion resistance. Okay. Remember. Remember examples. Carborundum, silica carbide, quartz, barium salts, asbestos, fillers. Okay. Some other fillers also I gave here. Wood floor. Wood floor and gypsum and marble floor, cotton fibers. Now, students, why we are using lubricants? Functioning, tell me.
Function. To make molding of plastic easier.
To make molding of plastic easier without sticking to the
fabrication
equipment. Fabrication equipment. Example. Example.
Oils,
soaps. Okay. Next, to catalyst we are using. Why? Why we are adding catalyst? Why we are adding catalyst?
To accelerate.
To accelerate. Okay, to accelerate. How it is converting?
Fusible resin to cross-linked forms.
Fusible resins to cross-linked forms. Okay, in which type of plastics we will use?
Thermosetting
resins. Okay, examples tell me. Catalyst example.
Hydrogen peroxide.
Hydrogen peroxide.
Benzoyl peroxide.
Benzoyl peroxide. One more.
Zinc oxide.
Zinc oxide. Okay. Okay. Stabilizers functioning. Stabilizers functioning.
To improve the thermal stability of plastics.
To improve the thermal stability of plastics. Examples. Examples.
Lead chromate.
Lead chromate.
White lead.
White lead. Two more examples, sir.
Barium cadmium.
Barium. Barium. Barium.
Barium stearate, cadmium stearate,
lead chromate, white lead, barium stearate, cadmium stearate. Now coloring materials, tell me why we have to add colors? Why we have to add colors?
To give them
desired color to plastic. To get a desired color to plastic. Example, some you tell me. I gave four here. At least two also you have to remember. Tell me.
Aluminium silicate, lead chromate.
Aluminium silicate.
Lead chromate.
Lead chromate. Okay. So two more are there. Iron ferrocyanin dyes and thallocyanin dyes. Okay, ma? Four colors I gave you. Remember these colors. And for each ingredient, why we are using, you have to know the function. Okay. So for each ingredient, you have to know the function and also examples you have to remember. Then you can write very easily. Now tell my students, what are the ingredients we are using? Tell me fast. What are the ingredients we are using? Tell me. We'll go to the next topic. Tell me, what are the ingredients we are using?
Resin.
Resin.
Plasticizers, fillers.
Plasticizers, fillers.
Stabilizers, lubricants.
Stabilizers, lubricants. Accelerators or catalyst.
Coloring materials.
Coloring materials. Okay. So everybody understood, ma, this topic, compounding of plastics?
Yes.
Okay, ma. So this you have to write neatly. Means you have to remember all the ingredients one by one. You have to write. For example, you are writing plasticizers. You write what is the function of plasticizers. Then you write example. Writing about fillers. Write what is the function of fillers you write. Then write example. So like that, each ingredient you have to remember. Write that ingredient. Then write function and example. Okay, na? So compounding plastics is the process of adding ingredients or chemical admixes which increase the physical properties of the molded products. Okay, so first you have to know what is compounding of plastics. Then you can write what are the ingredients we are taking. So one by one you have to write. Okay, you write two types of resins we are using. Then you can write plasticizers. Okay, you can follow fillers, stabilizers. Students, we completed this topic, ma. We'll take another topic. Okay, na? Just we won't discuss much in that topic. I will tell you what we are going to discuss. Okay, na? Because already here, what is the time now? Okay, only 2 minutes. Only 2 minutes, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, tell me you are studying. Ma, started preparation?
Yes, ma'am.
Water unit, only few questions are there. Okay, na? Students, yes. Everybody prepare water unit first, then you can read first unit. Okay, na?
Okay, ma'am.
EDTA method you read today. Today, 2 questions you prepare. Tomorrow, I will ask you. EDTA method and potable water ion exchange. I will tell you, ma. I will find out and tell you. Okay, na? About exam that. Okay, na? Students, today prepare ion exchange process and potable water and EDTA method, ma. Okay? Tomorrow, I will ask you. See the students, next topic is what we are going to discuss next is preparation properties and applications of polyvinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride. Nylon 66, Teflon, and one more also we have Bakelite. Okay. So in this, I didn't give you Bakelite, so I didn't type. So 4 we will read, ma. Preparation, each one. Properties, applications of polyvinyl chloride, nylon 66, Teflon, Bakelite. Students, preparation of polyvinyl chloride already we discussed, ma, in addition polymerization. Okay. So we are taking a number of vinyl chloride molecules, okay, and adding means going for the process of polymerization by adding catalyst benzoyl peroxide, applying heat and pressure, and we prepare polyvinyl chloride, okay. So here before preparing polyvinyl chloride, we will prepare the vinyl chloride. So vinyl chloride we are preparing by taking acetylene. Okay, acetylene with hydrochloric acid at 60 to 80 degrees centigrade in presence of catalyst we are using zinc chloride, metal chloride catalyst, and we prepare the vinyl chloride first. Okay, so we will take n number of vinyl chloride molecules, okay, in presence of benzoyl peroxide or hydrogen peroxide catalyst and apply the heat and pressure and we prepare the polyvinyl chloride. So this is the preparation of polyvinyl chloride. So already I told about mechanism also. Okay, next class what we discuss is what are the properties. I gave 5 points here. Then applications. Okay, now applications. So next class we will discuss, students. In the afternoon we are having, no, we will discuss this preparation properties and applications of PVC, nylon 66, Teflon, Bakelite. Okay, now shall I end the class?
Yes. Okay, ma'am.
Okay.